Hello everyone. In today's video, we will discuss questions related to moment of inertia. These are all previous year questions. First question you can see, this is of GATE 2020. The question says that which one of the following matrices does not represent a proper rotation in a plane? It's saying does not represent a proper rotation in a plane, and they have given four options. So we'll go with the options. But how to do this? For this, we need to know that the proper rotational, the determinant of the matrix for proper rotation, determinant of the matrix is what? Is plus 1. Okay, so we will go with the options. In the first option, that is option A, you see. Okay, let's go with the option. First option, it says minus sine theta cos theta minus cos theta sine theta. If we find the determinant, we will get minus sine square theta plus cos square theta. So this is not equals to 1. Minus sine theta cos theta. Oh, sorry. Here it is minus sine theta. So it is sine square theta. Yeah. So this is equals to 1. So from the first option, we are getting the value of the determinant equals to 1. Now the second option. Second option says, I am doing it here only. It will be easy. Second option is saying cos square theta minus minus plus sine square theta. So this is equals to 1. Third option they are saying sine square theta again minus minus plus cos square theta equals to 1. And fourth option it's saying minus sine square theta plus cos square theta, which is not equals to 1. So option D is our correct answer, because they have asked which does not represent a proper rotation in a plane. So our option D is the right answer. Okay, see, they have asked which one of the following matrices does not represent a proper rotation in a plane. The concept is what? For proper rotation, for proper rotation, determinant of the matrix is plus 1. This is the concept. Okay, now just go with the options and find the answer you will get. Okay, so our next question says what? It says that a system of four particles in XY plane. Of these two particles, each of mass m are located at minus 1, 1 and 1, minus 1. The remaining two particles, each of mass 2m, are located at what, 1 and minus 1, minus 1. The xy component of the moment of inertia tensor of the system of the particle is? This is a question from GATE 2006. Okay. So first, let us draw the coordinate axis. This is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. Okay, two particles of mass m are located at minus 1, 1. Okay, so this is minus 1. Let this be plus 1. This is 1 and this is minus 1. Okay, first particle is at minus 1, 1. That is here. Particle number 1 of mass m. Okay, particle 2 is at 1, minus 1. That is here, particle 2, that is also mass m. Third particle of mass 2m is at 1, 1, that is here. Third particle of mass 2m. And fourth particle is at minus 1, minus 1, that is here. With 2m. Okay, this is the fourth particle. Okay. So this is the system of four particles in the xy plane. Of this, two particles of mass m are located at this and this. Okay. So this is the system. Okay, now we need to find the xy component of the moment of inertia tensor. Okay, so xy component of moment of inertia tensor, we know what is the formula of it, right? We know from the definition that ixy, that is equals to iyx, correct? We know moment of inertia tensor I is what? We write in this way, we write this as ixx, ixy, ixz, iyx, iyy, I Y Z, I Z X, I Z Y, and I Z Z. Now they have asked the I X Y component. This is equals to I Y X component. Okay, that is equals to what? According to the definition, I X Y is equals to I Y X is equals to minus summation over M I X I Y I summation over I. Okay, where I is what? Number of the particles. Now you see, two particles are of mass m and two particles are of mass 2m. Two particles of mass m and two particles of mass 2m. Okay, so for mass m, we are doing first, mass m is at a distance of minus 1, 1 and 1, minus 1. Okay, so let us do it one by one, then we will add. Okay, so for mass m at location 1 comma minus 1 comma 1 and 1 comma minus 1, okay, minus 1 comma 1, we will have m minus 1 1, that is minus of m. Okay, for 1 comma minus 1, we will have m 1 minus 1, that is minus of m. Okay, now for 2m, we have at 1 1 and we have at minus 1 comma minus 1, so 2m 1 1, that is 2m, and 2m minus 1 minus 1 is equals to 2m. You have to take care of this minus signs. Okay, now we will add. There is a minus sign. Now minus m plus 2m plus 2m. Okay, so that is equals to minus of 2m plus 2m plus 2m. This will cancel out. We will get minus 2m. So this is our answer. Now let's see the options. Options D is correct. Okay, so you understood how to do a system of four particles in the xy plane. When you have to calculate Ixy, then you have, this is our formula. Okay, this is our formula. Now just substitute these values and you will get the answer. Okay, okay, now let's proceed to the third question. What does it say? It says that the moment of inertia, tensor of a rigid body, is given by I is equals to 80 minus 4 0 4 0 minus 4 0 8. The magnitude of the moment of inertia about an axis n cap equals to half root 3 by 2 comma 0 is. Okay, options are 6, 5, 2 and 8 by 3. Okay, so this is our question. Now there are two processes to do this question. First you read this question, understand it. This is question from GATE 2008. Okay, now I will tell you two process to do this type of question. One is the direct process, second you have to calculate with the matrix form. Okay, so now let's solve. See, the first process to do is I tension is given and along the direction n cap is given. Now okay, and along the direction, so half 3 by 2 root 3 by 2 0, and here we will write this matrix half root 3 by 2 0. So this is one process to do. Okay, that is moment of inertia about an axis which is along n cap direction is given as this. n cap is actually what? Nx, x cap plus ny, y cap plus nz, z cap. So this is the x component, this is the y component, and this is the z component. So to calculate our moment of inertia about an axis which is along n cap, we have to do in this way. Matrix form, you have to calculate the matrix and you will get the answer. Okay. But I am giving a direct process, second process, the direct process. This is what the moment of inertia I will be Ixx nx square plus Iyy ny square. This will be beneficial for you because it will save your time. Right, when we are giving an MCQ exam, our time is a major factor. So we need to know those formulas which will save our time. And also in this process, there will be less amount of silly mistakes. Calculation mistakes will be less. Okay, so this is the formula. See how to remember this formula. See Ixx with that Nx, Iyy with that Ny, Izz with that Nz. When you are doing Ixy, two factors is coming. When you are doing Ixy, two factors is coming. Okay. Now this will be Ixz. You can clearly see that these are product of two, like xy, yz, xz. Clear? 2 is multiplied in these three terms, and yz is there, then ny, nz. Xz is there, then nx, nz. Xy is there, then nx, ny. In this way, you have to remember the formula. Okay? So now we will substitute this value. Okay. See, Ixx is given as what? Okay, let me see the matrix again. 80 minus 4. Okay, let me write this here. I is equals to 80 minus 4. 80 minus 4. 040 minus 408. 040 minus 408. And n cap is half root 3 by 2 and 0. Okay. Now, Ixx, that is 8 into nx square. That is 1 by 4. Plus Iyy, that is 0, Izz, minus of 4, nz square 0, plus 2 Ixy, Ixy is this one, 0, plus Iyz, Iyz is 0, plus Ixz, Ixz is 8, into nx, nx is half, and nz, nz is 0, okay, so, Iyz is not there. Yes, Iyz is there. But Ny and Nz is 0. Okay, fine. So here we have done some mistake. That is, this Iyy component, this one is Iyy component. So here this term we will get. This is not 0. 4 and Iy square, that is this. That is 3 by 4. Okay. So what we are getting? 8 into 1 by 4, that is 2. Plus 4 into 3 by 4. That is 3. So our final answer is what? 5. Okay. So we are getting our answer I is equals to 5. Okay. You can also do by this process, check, you will get the answer 5 only. But remember this formula. This is more easy to do. Okay. Now, question number 4. This is question number 4. What does it say? It's saying that two masses MH are placed at the points X, Y, that is equals to A, A, and minus A, minus A, and two masses 2m each are placed at a distance, placed at the points A, minus A, and minus A, A. The principal. See, I am doing the PYQs, okay. So, I have assumed that you know some basic theory regarding MOI. That is moment of inertia tension. ओके एंड ऑल्सो वाइल डूइंग प्रीवाइक यू सम ऑफ योर कॉन्सेप्ट विल बी क्लियर बिकॉज वेन वी रीड द थ्योरी नो वी डोंट एग्जैक्टली नो हाउ टू यूज इट हाउ टू यूटिलाइज दिस ओके सो वाइल डूइंग द पीवाई क्यूज वी विल गेट टू नो हाउ टू सॉल्व अ क्वेश्चन सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ओके इफ देर इज एनी प्रॉब्लम रिगार्डिंग थ्योरी और रिगार्डिंग एनी कॉन्सेप्ट यू लेट मी नो आई विल ट्राई टू कवर दिस अप इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ओके यू कमेंट मी इन द कमेंट बॉक्स If you have any doubt, let me know. Okay. Okay. So this question is from NET December 15. NET December 15. Okay. What does it say? It's two masses M are there. And first, whenever you read a question, suppose in the exam, when you are solving any MCQ, okay. You will get rough pages. Just because now exams are like CBT, right? It's computer based. If OMR is there or if pen and paper based exam is there, then you can just highlight in the question paper itself. But if it is CBT, whenever you are getting that rough page, just write the key points. Okay, like here, two masses M, which are placed at this distances. And again, two masses 2M, which are placed at the points A, minus A and minus A, A. You have to find the principal moment of inertia of the system. So just write the key points in the paper so that your calculation will be faster. Okay. And try to solve each and every question in the rough paper, not just orally. Because whenever we try to solve orally, there is a maximum chance of silly mistakes. Okay. Now we.
The principal moment of inertia. Principal moment of inertia is basically the eigenvalue of the inertia matrix. Okay. So first we need to find the inertia matrix. We know the components are IXX, IXY, IXZ, IYX, IYY, IYZ, IZX, IZY, and IZZ. These are the components of the inertia tensor. Okay. Now we will find each component. Okay. For the product inertia, that is IXY, IXZ, and IYZ. Okay. Okay. This is equals to IYX, IZX, and IZY. This is equals to minus summation over MI. XI, YI, that is equals to minus summation over MI, ZI, XI, equals to minus summation over MI, ZI, YI. Okay. Now let us again go back to the question and let's see what they have said. They have said two masses are placed at the points AA and minus A, comma, minus A, right? Okay. So let's draw the figure. Two masses are at M at a distance A comma A, M at a distance minus A comma A, at a distance 2M minus A comma A, and at a distance 2M A comma minus A. Okay, so now we will calculate product of inertia for each case. Now for IYX or IXY, that is equals to minus summation over MI XI, YI, that is equals to minus M into XI, YI, that is A square, again minus M, that is plus M, minus A into A, that is minus A square, plus 2M, minus A into A, that is minus A square, plus 2M, A into minus A, that is minus A square. Okay, so this is our IXY. Now let's see which term gets cancelled out. Here we are getting minus M square, this will get cancelled out, plus 2M plus 2M, that is plus 4M A square, correct? So we are getting plus 4M A square. Have I done any mistake here? Okay, let's check once again what we have done. Here two masses M are at AA, this is correct. second mass m is there minus a comma minus a. So this is here m, not 2m. Okay. Then in the third one, 2m is there a comma minus a. A comma minus a. Okay, this is correct. And fourth one is there minus a comma a. Okay, so this is 2m. Okay. So here m a comma a, this is correct. M minus a comma a, correct. Plus 2m minus a comma a and plus 2m minus a comma a into a. Okay. Now, yes, there is one another mistake we have done. M is at minus a comma minus a. Yes. Okay. So this is at minus a comma minus a. So this is not minus, this is plus. So 2m square minus 2m square, this will get cancelled out, and here we will get not 4 but we will get 2m a square. Okay. So our value is minus 2m a square, and here this is already minus is there, so 2m a square. So ix is equals to ixy is equals to 2m a square. Now you see here the z component is 0. For this case we will get 0, and this case also we will get 0. Okay. So now we will find, our task is to find ixx, iyy and izz. Okay. So for ixx, how to do for ixx? Ixx we will do as summation over I m I. Okay. Since x is there, so yi square plus zi square. Okay. For y, mi xi square plus yi square. Okay. This is for summation over I mi xi square plus yi square. And here clearly you can see I have done yi, but it will be zi square. Okay. So calculation is easy because here zi we will get it 0. So for the masses of m, see one thing, you will see that here there is no minus sign. Okay, this is, there is no minus sign. Here we are getting a minus sign. You remember these things. Okay, more and more you will practice, you will get habituated with this. Okay. Yi square plus zi square. Zi square is not there, so we don't have. See, whatever square is there, it will be plus positive only. So we don't need to see now. So a square plus a square plus a square plus a square. Correct. And here there is 2m square, so multiply with 2. So this we are getting is what? 6m a square. Okay. Now here again, similar way we will get a square a square. Mass is 2m a square, so we will get here 2a square. So we will get here 6m a square. So this way, this was easy because both this component was 0. Now here m a square plus y square, a square plus a square plus a square. For 2 mass 2, a square plus a square. For 2 mass again 2, a square plus a square. So how much we will get? 2a square, 4a square. For here 4a square, that is 8a square. And for here 4a square, that is 12m a square. Okay. So now finally we will get the, we will get all the values, and we will substitute this for ixy and iyx. We are getting 2m a square. Okay. So this is 2m a square, this is 2m a square. Ixx we are getting 6m a square, this is 6m a square. This we are getting 12m a square, this is we are getting 0, 0, 0, 0. Now to find the, what they have asked in the question, to find the principal moment of inertia, we need to find the eigenvalues. Okay. So now eigenvalues, for finding the eigenvalue, we will use this equation. Here this is I, so make this I dash. So I dash minus lambda I equals to 0. This is the unit matrix. So what we are getting is 6m a square minus lambda 2m a square 0, 6m a square minus lambda 0, 12m a square minus lambda 0, 0, 2m a square. Okay, this is equals to 0. Now we will solve this. So what we will get? 6m a square minus lambda, 6m a square minus lambda, 12m a square minus lambda, and this we are getting 2m a square 0, and then we will get one term 2m a square into 12 m a square minus lambda, and this is 0. Okay, so this is equals to 0. So we are getting 6 m a square minus lambda, 6 m a square minus lambda. This term we are taking common, okay, 2 m a square, that is 4 m square a to the power 4. We are taking common 12 m a square minus lambda, that is equals to 0. Okay, 6 m a square minus lambda whole square plus 2 m a square whole square equals to 0. Okay, so from here we can get one equation, that 12 m a square minus lambda equals to 0. So one, we are getting value lambda is equals to 12 m a square. Okay, so from here also we will get two values. Now you see, I have told you in one lecture that how to calculate the value of lambda without calculation, right? We know this, I am doing it here. We know trace of a matrix is equals to lambda 1 plus lambda 2 plus lambda 3. Here trace is what? 6 plus 6, 12 plus 12, that is 24 m a square. Okay, so this is 1. So if 24 can be what? One answer we already got, 12. So plus 6 and 6 will give us 24, or 12 plus 4 plus 8 will give us 24, right? Okay, now if we find the determinant of this, or many more combination are possible, but let us first find the determinant. See, determinant of this is 6 m a square, okay, this into this, that is 6 into 12, that is 72, the 72 m a square, okay. And if we do this plus 2 m a square, then we will get minus 2 into 12, that is 24 m a square. If we calculate this, okay, if we calculate this, we will get 672 into 6, that is 432 minus 24 into 2, that is 48, that is 384. So we need the product as 384. Okay, now let's see where we are getting. 4 into 8 is what? 32. 32 into 12. 12 2 is 24. 2 carry. 12 3 is 36. 384. Wow. I got in first chance only. So this is our eigenvalues, 12, 4 and 8. Okay, you can also calculate this, is general process I have shown. Sorry. So by the general process you can do. But I got my answer as lambda 1 as 12, lambda 2 as 8 m a square, and lambda 3 as 4 m a square. Okay, so this is my answer. Now let us go through the options. We are getting what? 12, 8 and 4. Okay, so here, see, 8 and 4, this is correct. Because 4 and 4 we are not getting, 2 and 4 we are not getting, 8 and 8 we are not getting. So our correct answer is which one? This is our correct answer. Okay, so I hope you understood. Okay, so our next question is, a rigid body is rotating about its center of mass fixed at the origin with an angular velocity omega and angular acceleration a. If the torque acting on it is tau and its angular momentum is L, the rate of change of its kinetic energy is half tau dot omega half L dot omega half tau dot omega plus L dot alpha plus sorry D half L dot alpha. Okay, the terms, I hope you know what these terms mean. Okay, now in question they have said that a rigid body about its center of mass fixed at the origin with an angular velocity omega and angular acceleration alpha. If the torque acting on it is tau and its angular momentum is L, we need to find the rate of change of its kinetic energy. Okay, we know kinetic energy is equals to what? Half L dot omega. Right? We know this. Now they have asked us to find the rate of change of kinetic energy. So very easy. dL dt dot omega plus L dot d omega dt. Now we know what? dL dt is nothing but tau, that is torque, rate of change of angular momentum is equals to torque plus L dot. D omega dt is what? Angular acceleration, alpha. Correct? So this is our answer. Very easy. Answer C is correct. This is very easy question. Just the thing is that you need to know this, that kinetic energy T is equals to half L dot omega. Okay, so this was question from, this is a GATE question. This is a GATE, I think 2006 or 2008. Okay, today we will stop here only. Okay, I hope you understood how to do questions related to moment of inertia. I have done almost all the varieties of questions so that you would understand when, which question, what has asked, and you can proceed in that way. Okay, next, in my next lecture, you can suggest me that you want PYQ related to which topic. Okay, because I think in my next lecture, I will it will be a problem solving video. So, if you have any suggestion or if you want for any particular topic, let me know. Okay. Thank you so much. Keep studying. Bye-bye.